You know what, man? Maybe talk to this guy and say you're better off selling this thing right now.
I was talking to this guy over Facebook, and I sent him a quick message because he had a deal to run by me. We were just talking about a private deal in West Vancouver, which is a crazy market right now.
Shit, this was gonna be a very difficult one for multiple reasons. Number one, that value of $3 million, I don't think it's there. That's gonna be definitely much, much lower in today's market. Now, what's the exit anyways for us? Yeah, this one might be a challenge, dude. Just location, number one, and then there's no real clear exit. And here's my other thing, right? Like, I do not, with the numbers that we're seeing, I do not see the market going up for 2019. And if that continues and the market continues going down, I'm guessing this three right now in October is probably like maybe 2.8. A year from now, would that be down to like 2.5? And then we got what, like 2 million on 2.5? Like that's our challenge today, man. Even though we're busy, our challenge is, what is this market gonna be in the next 365 days? And can we get out of it? Sure, it looks safe right now, but not in the long run.
I don't see the market coming back anytime soon, especially in areas like that where, you know, that house probably, you know, 2 years ago, probably some for 4 million. Now it's at maybe 3.5 million. Now it's at 3 million. That new appraisal that we're gonna order, is that gonna be coming in at 3? Is it gonna come in at 2.5? And a year from now, is it gonna be 2.5 or is it gonna be 2.2? You got a $2 million mortgage against it, you're underwater already.
You know what, man? Maybe talk to this guy and say you're better off selling this thing right now and then coming back in a year from now or 2 years from now and buying something for a little cheaper. They'll all be interested. I'm just looking after this guy. Like, everyone wants the money, right? They all want the commission on this guy, so I get that. I'm just looking after this guy because maybe if he can't sell it, then what happens then? This guy's, he's stuck now. He's got two assets that are somewhat depreciating, and how the hell do I get my money out of here?
What did you turn down? What was the dollar figure?
What do you mean? The commission?
Yeah,
amount?
I guess it would have been.
Probably 14,000 to 15,000 in commission is what it turned down. But that doesn't matter. At the end of the day, what matters is, you know, what was the best advice I gave to the client? And in this instance, that client is a mortgage broker. Now, did I lose the deal? Yes, I did. Did I lose that client? No, he'll call me back for sure, because I added other value there. Every time I get into any type of deal, I look at how am I adding value to somebody else, not how am I adding value to myself. So in this case here, sure, I lost a commission check, and maybe some other lender will do it. Fine, they can make that money. I'm happy with that. It's all good. Adding value to the end user. It's the first thing you should look at, not the amount of money you're gonna be making off this deal. Or the great thing about this guy is, I lost the deal, I turned the deal down, but I'm gonna definitely see more. He's already coming into my office end of this month, and we're gonna be chatting about some other things and another venture he's doing that's not even related to mortgage industry. And that's how a lot of my clients come from. I give somebody great advice, they take it, some don't, some do. And if I give somebody great advice, guess what? They're gonna be referring, and that's what I count on.